Hello everyone, welcome to the learning of engineering tutorial video lectures. In this video lectures, we are trying to learn some assumptions we are making for the derivation of the mathematical model for the torsional shaft. As we know, the shaft is widely using to transmit the power from one unit to the another unit. So best example you can take it, if you take any automobile like four wheels or the bus or car, whatever it may be. So in this case, the engine is going to be generating the power. That power is going to be transmitting to the different transmitting units. Just like there's going to be a gearbox is there, propeller shaft is there, differential box. There we can see most of the time these gear blanks also mounted on the shaft, which is going to be made to rotate. So this way, the power, that means each shaft is going to be subjected to certain type of the torsional forces, and then the shear forces are going to be generating and shear stresses also going to be generating. So in this case, what the main purpose of this video? So in this case, what is that? Some assumptions we are going to be making. So why we have to make these assumptions? We know the mathematical model, the meant for to analyze the linearity of the system. When there is a non-linearity is there, so then what will happen? We are trying to take it into the linearity. For example, here, there is a ductile material, the stress as well as the strain curve we are going to be drawing here. So there we can see here, so there is going to be a brittle materials or ductile materials, suppose we are going to be getting this kind of the curve. So can you see, this proportional limit is going to be existed up to the certain point, either elastic limit or proportional limit. So then what happened when I'm going to be draw a line, it's going to be matching exactly. It is the linearity is existing, but after that, the behavior of that material will show is the non-linearity. It is called non-linear curve. So then what I'm going to do? So we don't have that level of mathematical models, but we are trying to convert into the linearity. That means the linear model. So then what I'm going to do? I'm going to be draw a certain tangents from here. So there we can see by using this one. So from this point to this point, I'm going to be converting into the linearity, and then I will assess or analyze the behavior of the system. From this point to this point, and can you see here? So those are the different points we have taken, and I'm going to be draw a tangent to that curve, and then I can convert into the linearity, then I can solve the mathematical models. So this way, the non-linearity is going to be converted into the linearity, and then we are going to be analyzing the behavior of the system. Now come to the point here. What is the assumptions? Why we have to make it? Already we answered that. And then what type of assumptions we can make it, right? So if you want to get the linearity, in this case, all the things must be in the linear condition. Suppose the first one I'm going to read out, the material shaft is homogeneous. Can you see? The material shaft is the homogeneous and isotropic. In terms of the homogeneous, I can say the material distribution throughout the shaft is going to be the constant. Suppose I'm going to be taking a shaft over here. So it's going to be representing, it's representing the shaft. So then in this case, what will happen? The material distribution from point 1 to 2 is going to be the homogeneous, right? At the same time, it is existed the isotropic. Isotropic means here, what is the properties of the system like tensile strength, compressive strength, or torsional strength are going to be the uniform throughout the length of the member. So this is going to be your the length, and this is going to be the diameter of the shaft. In terms of the diameter and the length, homogeneous is going to be a constant, isotropic also the constant here. The next, the shaft is uniform circular cross section throughout the member. So when it is going to be the cross section over here, it is going to be, suppose 10 mm diameter is there. And throughout the length, it's maintained the 10 mm diameter. On that basis, we are going to be calculating the math, or we are deriving the mathematical model. Next one, the applied twist along the shaft is uniform. Suppose we are going to be applying the twist over here. Suppose I'm going to be applying the twist over here. So then what will happen? The throughout, suppose we are going to be taking in the cross section. So this is going to be the cross section of this member. So when I'm applying the twist over here, the throughout the cross section, right? And the length is going to be the uniform twist is going to be generating, right? That is the assumption here. Next, the cross section of the shaft, which are plane before as well as after twist. So in this case, so there are the two conditions we are taking. We are applying the twist over here, right? So then what happened? The cross section, suppose you can take the any cross section of this one, the before as well as the after, it's going to be remain, it will maintain its original cross section. And the original cross section here is going to be the circularity. The next one, all radii, which are straight before after the a twist in this case. So in this case, what will happen? The radius. That means we mentioned the cross section is going to remain the constant here. It means that that radius, whatever you are going to be considering before and after, it's going to be remaining the same. So that basis we are going to be taking. So here assumptions are going to be like this. So on this basis, we are going to be generating the mathematical model, and we are going to find out the torsional stresses as well as the torque or other parameters. Easily we can calculate it. So any mathematical model, it is required some assumptions, so that we are converting into the non-linearity into the linear conditions, and then we are going to be deriving the equations, and that whatever the behavior it is showing, that's going to be in the satisfactory level, so that we can design any kind of the components. I hope you are able to understand what we have discussed here, and still if you feel any difficulty, and please put in the comment section so that I can reach out. So thank you.